So as I'm getting ready to pack for the next road trip, I'd like to share with you guys a couple of my tips, my best advice on how I manage to pack very minimal every time we travel with the family. So stay tuned. Hello everybody, welcome back to our channel. My name is Alessandra, I'm the mom from This Is How We Rock, and I like to upload videos about family minimalism and simple living. So I'm married to my husband, Bay Sparks, who is a professional musician, and together we have 5 kids, and we like to travel all over the world with them, having all kinds of fun and adventures, and we like to share them in a family vlog. So if you would like to stick around, you are welcome. Please hit the subscribe button down below and tap the bell so you don't miss any of my videos. And now let's get started. So consider, you guys, that we've been traveling with the kids since the day they were born. Well, a couple of days after they left the hospital, basically. So they're professional travelers. They love traveling. They love learning something new every time. And I'm starting to wonder, they probably would have had better tips to share with you guys than the ones I'm gonna be giving you. But let's get started. So tip number one, in order for me to pack very light for my family 7, is to make sure that I jot down all the different activities and events we're gonna be attending while on vacation. So if there's any concert my husband will be playing during those dates, or if there's any sightseeing we managed to squeeze in, or a trip to the beach, I like to have everything written because it helps me to narrow down the number of outfits I'm gonna be carrying for my family. So my next tip would be making sure you pack neutral colors. And that helps because it's like carrying a capsule wardrobe with you through the entire vacation. And out of 3 outfits, for example, you can make 12 different ones. So definitely pack neutral colors. But I like to take this tip one step farther. Wow, say it again just for fun. I like to take this tip one step farther. And I like to bring colors that they blend and they match the palette of colors of our destination. So let's say in this trip, we're gonna be crossing India and Palm Springs, so the Californian desert. And I like to bring our yellow ochre outfits or the olive green. And since we're gonna be spending time on the West Coast as well, I like to bring striped tops or all the different shades of blues. So my next tip would be making sure you know the right timing for you to start packing, because you don't want to pack too late, obviously, but you don't want to end up packing too early either, because what happened to me in the past is that we started to leave out of our suitcase even before we reached our destination, and that wasn't fun. And that makes you forget things behind, because you're still going to be using the pieces of clothing you're going to be taking with you. But if you pack like what works for us is 5 days to a week prior departure date, I realized that we can live easily without those items that we're gonna be taking with us and they're already packed. Do the laundry. Have all your clothes ready and accessible, ready to be packed, because I've done this before. I had everything packed except for a couple of items that were still like in the dryer. And I ended up just carrying them in those classy looking plastic bags beside my suitcases, and I don't want to do that anymore. So I want to make sure that I have everything ready right then when I'm ready to pack. So definitely do the laundry and have everything accessible. My next tip is check on the weather of your destination, or better, don't trust the weather and have a packing list. I know that this sounds very simple, but you must have a packing list. What happened to us in the past is that we ended up forgetting very important stuff like our memory cards for our cameras, or a tripod, or a rain jacket. I remember the one time that we were in Legoland and I forgot to pack a rain jacket. So we had to buy rain jackets for all 7 of us, and it wasn't fun either. So definitely have a packing list. And what I do is that I keep our template on a desktop, and it's ready to be printed every time we're going somewhere. So all I do is just a couple of adjustments depending on our destination, like if we're going to the beach or the mountains and we need specific gear, or if it's a work-related trip and we need recording equipment, or also if you have medications you need to take with you and documents in order not to forget them. So a packing list is a must. My next tip is having a designated area to dump all the stuff as you remember it, to take with you. So what I like to do is like having my suitcase open a week before we leave and start dumping the stuff that I know that we're gonna need once we leave. So that's my dumping station. It can be your bed, it can be a blanket on the floor, And once you have your packing list, it makes it so much easier to know what you're gonna put in there. And it helps to see how much stuff you're gonna be taking, if there's anything you can leave behind. And my next tip is a kind of a personal tip, which is ironing the clothes. I know it's time consuming and many of you don't want to do that, it's fine, but it works for me in a way that makes my clothes flatter and easier to squeeze in a suitcase, and also it helps me to feel a little bit more put together once we reach a destination, especially after a long road trip or a long flight. And my last tip is packing reusable items. So I like to think that we leave the place we're going to the same way we found it, if not even better. So I like to bring with us our water filters, our glass water bottles, our coffee mugs, and also eco-friendly products as hygiene products, which I use anyways when we're home. And if you want to check out the video about my skincare routine, you'll see that most of my items come out of my pantry. So I'll leave a link down below. So definitely I pack multi-purpose items like baking soda, which works perfect for facial cleanser or laundry detergent, or also I like to sprinkle a little bit in our shoes at the end of the day, so it works as an odor control and it makes our shoes feel like brand new the next day. So this is it for today. I'm gonna be filming a couple of more videos about the same topic on like what I pack on my diaper bag and what I pack for myself. So definitely look forward to those. But in the meantime, you guys, please give this video a big thumbs up if you like. It helps the channel very much and is greatly appreciated. And I will catch you in the next video, you guys. Bye-bye.